Here's how the flywheel works step by step. The input to the flywheel is logs collected from an agentic application running in production, as depicted on the left side of this diagram. These logs can include user and agent interactions, as well as potential user feedback. The application is instrumented to collect these logs, which are then uploaded to Elasticsearch. This makes it available to the Orchestrator service, which is the brain of the flywheel. It is a unified control plane that abstracts the complexity of interacting directly with NeMo microservices. The Orchestrator runs a series of experiments on one or more candidate models as configured in your search space. These can include zero-shot or in-context learning evaluations using NeMo Evaluator, or even fine-tuning using NeMo Customizer followed by evaluation. The evaluation benchmarks thus reported can then be used to determine if there is a suitable candidate that can replace the larger model you have running in your production application. This reduces the cost of ownership by serving faster and leaner models, all this by leveraging live production traffic data for distilling your existing model. This data flywheel service is available as a set of Docker containers that can be deployed anywhere on cloud data centers or the edge. It exposes simple-to-use REST APIs to schedule and monitor your flywheel jobs, interacting with the NeMo microservices platform on your behalf. Now, we will demonstrate how the system can be used to optimize a customer service agent for tool calling, with the objective of identifying a more efficient NIN that can match the performance of the Llama 3.370B model, which is running by default. To simplify the setup, we will use NVIDIA Brev launchables, which are pre-configured GPU development environments, and that have some of the prerequisites and dependencies pre-installed out of the box. Let's take a look at the demo now. You can find the Data Flywheel Blueprint launchable at build.nvidia.com, where you can access both the open source code on GitHub, as well as deploy the notebook with the Deploy on Cloud button over here. This will take you to the launchable page, where you can deploy it with one click. Now I do have my launchable already deployed over here, so I'm just going to go and click on Open Notebook. And this will take me to the Jupyter Notebook. The first thing that you will see over here is that there is an architecture diagram of the Data Flywheel Blueprint and how it operates with the NeMo microservices platform. The specific application in focus today is that of an AI virtual assistant for customer service. This agent, or multi-agent system rather, it answers questions about product purchases on an e-commerce website. These questions can include requests for product details, order status checks, return processing, as well as small talk and casual engagement. You can find more information about this AI virtual assistant application at build.nvidia.com, as well as an associated blueprint card for it. However, for the purposes of this data flywheel blueprint, you will simply leverage the user and agent interaction logs generated from that multi-agent system. And you will use these logs to improve the various candidate models involved. Now let's go right ahead and get started with the setup portion of this. The first thing that you want to do is set an NGC API key, followed by cloning the Data Flywheel Blueprint GitHub repo, setting the right paths and dependencies, and then finally we set the configuration for the blueprint. Now, this is a very important cell. The first configuration we make is to set the LLM judge model and point it to a remote endpoint. By doing so, we don't need to deploy this model locally, and we can simply hit that external endpoint to run evaluations on the candidate NIMs in our search space. Second configuration that you will see over here is to select the candidate NIMs that should be part of your search space and whether or not the blueprint should try customizing it. Finally, once we take these configurations, we can get started to deploy first the NeMo microservices platform, followed by the Data Flywheel service. Once these services are deployed, you can optionally configure MLflow for detailed logging of model evaluations as part of the Data Flywheel. And you can do so by running this Docker Compose command over here. Once all these services are running, we're all set to get started. The next step now is to load the sample data provided. This data includes a timestamp of the interaction from the time the request was issued, a workload ID that represents a specific agent node that was logged at. This is especially important in multi-agent systems. A client ID that represents the application itself and is unique to it. A request that was sent to the model. This is in OpenAI chat completion format. And this is followed by a response from the llama, by default, a llama 3.370B model, followed by a response, which is by default from a llama 3.370B instruct model. And that is the model that we're trying to distill using this blueprint. Finally, we load that data using Elasticsearch. Followed by that, we can create a flywheel job by sending a post request to the jobs API. This will return with a job ID that you can actually use to monitor the job status by sending a get request to the job/job ID API. You will see certain artifacts of the job reported over here. However, this is an asynchronous call, and so it will return the current status. You will note that in the job status output, after certain evaluations are completed, you will see the following three metrics. In this case, the use case was pertaining to tool calling. And so the metrics it will report is that of tool calling evaluation. Namely, the first is the function name accuracy, which is an exact match metric. It checks if the predicted function name exactly matches the ground truth function name. There's the function name plus args accuracy, which is also an exact match metric on both the function name as well as the arguments. It checks if both the function name and args exactly match the ground truth. Now, this is a very strict metric. And so it will be interesting to see how it does in this use case. And the reason is because there are some queries or some arguments that are passed down to tools which are rather long strings. So even if the predicted argument is off by a character, this exact match metric will mark it as zero. And so that is exactly why we also have this function name and args accuracy LLN judge metric, which will actually check the arguments for semantic similarity. And so it will capture intent that way. Finally, to view the evaluation results, once they're ready, you can use the MLflow integration that we have at port 5000. So if you're using this via the Brev launchable route, you can actually find that dashboard right over here in the secure link section at port 5000. Let's click on this one. We'll take you to the MLflow dashboard. And you can see that I have three experiments that are captured over here. The specific cell that was running was this one with 300 data points. You'll observe that there are three different models logged over here, the llama 3.21b, 3.23b, and llama 3.18b models across three different types of evaluation. First for the base model, then for few-shot learning or in-context learning evaluation, and finally evaluating a customized version of it. So you can go ahead and select them and compare these runs. MLflow will report detailed evaluation results, including a lot of different kinds of metrics. Let's try to look at a scatter plot of the run name, which will be specific to the models and the type of evaluation that was run on them. And let's take a look at the mean correctness rating, which is the LLM judge metric for both function name and args. So here we can see that the llama 3.18b is outperforming the rest so far, and this is just on 300 data points. It scores close to 75% on this specific metric. Note that 100% on this data set means that it is 100% close to the llama 3.370B model, which is the one that it's trying to distill.